Squaring a circle means making a square with an area of a circle. Let's see why this can't be done. Let's choose a circle with a radius of 1 unit. We know that the area of a circle with radius r is pi r square. So for this circle, the area will be pi, as the radius is 1. So the problem now is to make a square with area pi. This means that the length of a side of the square should be the square root of pi. So the problem of squaring a circle now broke down to making a line of length square root of pi. Now this is where the trouble begins. Turns out pi is a member of a number group called irrational numbers. Irrational numbers are numbers that cannot be expressed as fractions. And rational numbers are numbers that can be expressed as fractions. Now some examples for irrational numbers are pi, e, root 2, etc. From this example, you can find one more interesting property. It is that rational numbers, when expressed as decimal, either ends at a particular number of digits after the decimal point or continues repeating a pattern like 0.6666. Whereas irrational numbers are never-ending decimal numbers with no repeating pattern. This is the key to understanding why our problem is impossible to solve. As pi is an irrational number, we can't ever find out the exact value of pi. Its decimal go on forever. So we can't know root pi, and this leads us to not being able to make a line of length root pi, which proves that we can't square a circle accurately. But there is one little mistake in this explanation. Even being an irrational number, it is possible to make a line of length root 2 accurately. We can do this simply by creating a right angle triangle with two sides 1 cm. And the third side will be exactly root 2 as per the Pythagoras law. So what makes pi different from root 2? This is where another number classification comes into play. Pi is not only irrational, but also a transcendental number. A transcendental number is a complex number that is not a root or solution of a non-zero polynomial equation. Numbers that are not transcendental are called algebraic, and they can be expressed as a solution of polynomial equation. This is what makes pi different from root 2. So it turns out you can't make a line of length a transcendental number like pi. So this transcendental nature of pi makes our problem impossible. Thanks for watching.